coastal sage scrub once dominated our central and southern California coast. It forms a lush gray-green canopy of shoulder-high shrubs with interlocking branches. Appearing uniform from a distance, closer inspection reveals a highly diverse mix of species. This is its story. The most defining element of the sage scrub environment is the pattern of our rainfall. We have relatively wet winters, which brings much growth and greening to our sage scrub. But starting in the late spring, high pressure systems push storms offshore or to the north. During these long droughts, many of our native plants become dry and dormant or deciduous. These wet winters and summer droughts define our Mediterranean climate, shared with just five other regions worldwide. In the past 2 million years, several glacial periods have caused the sea level to rise and fall hundreds of feet. Wave action on these changing shorelines and tectonic uplifting carved out marine terraces at many elevations. The uplifting of riverbeds created similar terracing. The grinding of the Pacific plate moving laterally against the North American plate lifted ancient seabeds thousands of feet. This uplifting of our seabeds is a continuing process. Sage scrub frames some of our most sensitive habitats. The most common plant in coastal sage scrub is the sagebrush. But we have several other subdominant species. Following are a few of the many other perennials within sage scrub. There are several dwarf trees found in coastal sage scrub. We have many annuals, each a delight to the eye. But coastal sage scrub is under siege. We have lost 90% of our coastal sage scrub habitat. Our Southern California coastline has been heavily developed. Perhaps less obvious, our rural areas have been similarly transformed. In San Luis Obispo County, ranching and agriculture have removed most coastal sage scrub, and a drive along Santa Barbara County's north coast evidences much of the same. Inland San Diego County's once natural rolling hills are almost entirely gentlemen's farms and ranches, even in the most inaccessible spots. Fragments of the former rich sage scrub community remain, a reminder of what has been lost. Our sage scrub habitat is greatly reduced or degraded, with invasive species forming monocultures in which few native animals nest or forage. 25 years after removal of feral sheep, there is no sign that sage scrub has jumped the fence to reclaim historic habitat on Santa Cruz Island. Coastal sage scrub provides habitat for many important species that forage and nest and are dependent on this unique plant community. Sage scrub recycles our carbon, filters our water, replenishes our oxygen, and restores our spirit. We only have one natural environment, and once lost, it can never be fully regained. Coastal sage scrub, an essential resource, a valued heritage.
Why doesn't the breeze delight?